Welcome back to Google class. Today I am going to discuss with it Indian Penal Code. Last video class we discussed section 304B of the IPC, a meaning of dowry, okay, definition of dowry, and section 304B IPC and section 2 of Dowry Prohibition Act 1961 and related reference cases also. Okay, today I'm going to discuss the same section 304B, but the section 2 of Dowry Prohibition Act 1961 explained, no, the parties, husband or relations and parents or either party. Okay, so how these peoples are affected in this section. Okay, so what is the meaning of the husband as per the Dowry Prohibition Act, and relatives of husband, how these peoples are related this dowry harassments. Okay, so let's start meaning of husband in this 304B of IPC. It's related to dowry. Okay, getting money from the wife father. Okay, so the meaning of husband, it would be appropriate to construe the expression husband to cover a person who enters into marital relationship, and under the color of such proclaimed or feigned status of husband, subject the woman concerned to cruelty, okay, or coerce in her any manner or for any of the purpose enumerated in the relevant provisions, section 304B IPC or section 498A of Indian Penal Code, whatever be the legitimacy of the marriage itself for the limited purpose of section 498A and 304B of Indian Penal Code. Such an interpretation, known and recognized a purposive construction as to come into play in the case of this nature, the absence of definition of husband to specifically include such persons who contract marriages ostensibly and cohabitate with such women in the purport exercise of his role and status as husband is no ground to exclude them from the purview of section 304B or 498A of IPC. In this viewed in the context of the very object and aim of the legislations introducing the above those provisions. Okay, and the second point of view, the relative of the husband, how they are related in this offense. The word relative of the husband in section 304B of the IPC would mean such persons who are related by blood, marriage or adoption. The brother of the aunt of the husband is not a relative. And another definition, soon before death. The word soon before death, okay, attract the provision of section 304 of IPC. Soon before yet. Yetting is soon before death. What is this? I'll explain you. One of the main ingredients of the offense which is required to be established is that soon before her death she was subjected to cruelty and harassment in connection with the demand for dowry. The provision does not employ the term at any time before or immediately before and must be construed according to its true import. The expression "soon before our death" cannot be given a restricted or narrower meaning. They must be understood in their plain language and with reference to their meaning in common parlance. These are the provisions relating to human behavior and therefore cannot be given such a narrower meaning, which would defeat the very purpose of the provision of the Act. Of course, there are penal provisions and must receive strict conditions, but even the rule of strict construction requires that provisions have to be read in conjunction with other relevant provisions and scheme of the Act. Further, the interpretation given should be one which would avoid absurd results on the one hand and would further the object and cause of the law so enacted on the other. The legislative object in providing such a radius of time by employing the words "soon before death" is to emphasize the idea of that a death should, in all probabilities, has been aftermath of such cruelty or harassment. In other words, there should be a reasonable, if not direct, nexus between our death and the dowry related cruelty or harassment inflicted on her. There was a demand of Maruti car being pressed by the two accused person. Okay, Maruti car being pressed by the two accused persons after about 6 months of the marriage of the deceased. Okay, we took place about 3 years before the incident. Okay, and after being pestered, nagged, tortured and maltreated on non-fulfillment of the said demand, which was conveyed by her to her parents from time to time on her visits to her parental home and on telephone, she might have thought that things would improve with the passage of time, but it seems that did not happen. It, however, cannot be taken mean that the demand made by the two accused persons had subsided or was given up by them. Okay, the test of soon before is satisfied in the facts, evidence and circumstances of the present case. Evidence that the deceased told her mother 1 month prior to her unnatural death that the accused husband used to subject her to cruelty was held to be not within the four corners of the time frame where the death occurred. After 5 days of the demand dowry, it was considered to be soon before death. Okay, the expression "soon before" is a relative term. It has to be construed in the context of specific circumstances of each case. No hard and fast rule of universal application can be laid down by prescribing a time limit. These words are to be understood in relative and flexible sense. There can be no fixed period of time in this regard. If the incident alleged of cruelty is remote in time and has become ineffective, so as not to disturb the mental equilibrium of the victim concerned, it would be of no consequence. Where the death was due to electrocution, and there is evidence that the victim was subjected to cruelty demanding a motorbike, it was held that harassment made 15 to 20 days before her death was considered to be soon before her death. Cruelty caused to her, that is the deceased, on any day from the date of her marriage, that is 20th April 1994 till the date of her death, 22nd July 1994, could be cruelty caused soon before her death. Okay, these are all tests. And another thing, the proximity test is available. Okay, I'll give you detailed explanation to another video class because it is easy to understand. Okay, proximity test is a good test. The expression soon before her death, okay, used in section 304 IPC. Okay students, we'll discuss with next class this proximity test. Okay, take care, bye.